a little statue dude there. Here we got a just dead-ass forest. When I first played this, I was like, where the heck is this? And I'm like, it sort of looks like in The Hobbit, where they were, you know, attacked by those spiders, because it's like, you know, there's all this forest, and then all of a sudden everything's just kind of dead and weird, and there's, like, spiders everywhere. So, I don't think this is it, though, because I don't feel like... I don't know much about, you know, Middle-earth geography, but I don't think this is it, so I don't know. Whatever. Just somewhere. They have different colors, and the different, like, the font is in different colors for different enemies. I don't know exactly what that means. I know that it has something to do with, like, I think, like, pink. Like, sometimes, I know that pink is for one of the characters later on that's, like, you know, a major, like, a boss, sort of. So I don't know if that's the case there. Really, it's like, oh, he's orange, that would be worse. But it's something like that. There is something based on that, I just don't know entirely what it is. One thing that always seemed kind of odd to me is that they treat the orcs like, I don't know, like, completely inhuman. Which, I mean, I know they're not human, they're orcs, but I mean, there's a lot of other people that aren't orcs, dwarves and elves and stuff, hobbits. So, but they treat the orcs like they're not, like, it's almost like they're not sentient. Like, they just treat them like, oh, it's a monster, not like, this is a dude. Because they talk. Like, they talk in the movies and in the books and everything, and they have, like, plans and they have leaders and stuff. Like, oh, hey, that I like that orc, he strategizes well. So it's kind of weird to me. Like, I mean, they would still kill them anyway, because, like, you know, the elves and dwarves fought, you know, all these other places fought, so whatever. But, I don't know, it's just weird how they approach it, I think. And the Uruk-hai, too, because I think the Uruk-hai talk a little bit. I don't think they talk as much. I'm probably totally wrong on that, but I don't know. And the Uruk-hai, too, they're actually, like, elves that are, like, messed with. I love those big, like, birthing pits. We're just like, here's some mud, and we're just yanking it out of there. I don't know exactly how the heck that thing works. I just love it, though. Like, I'm not really sure. It's like, they said that they're like, you know, oh, we just messed around with elves, but, like, are they stealing elves in general? Do they have to keep stealing elves? Are they like, we got one and we're good to go, we're just cloning them? Like, I don't know. Long bottom leaf. That's the Neville's special brand of bleed. I love when he yells and they all yell like in response. And he kinda he's like, huh? Huh? Like, huh? And they're like, yeah. Well, yeah, we agree. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You betcha. I wish when you hit the orcs with the loud water fear, it would just clean them. It'd be all nice and fresh, you know? Like, hey, it doesn't smell so bad. Thanks, Israel. You know? That's all they want. That's not the reason they're attacking people. They're just dirty. They don't know proper hygiene. You know? They're teaching. How are they expected to get jobs if they're all dirty and stuff? It's, to clean them up. Another thing, I don't know why the orcs wear clothes. Like, if they're supposed to be monsters, per se. You know, they want to just run around naked just attacking people. I don't know. Do orcs have dicks? Whatever. I'm a equal opportunity for the orcs and whatnot, but, yeah. I don't know. Because you don't see female orcs, do you? I mean, I guess there must be some, I think. I don't know. But you never see them. And you have female warriors, at least on the good side. You would think on the evil side, they'd be like, hey, let's use everybody we can. So. Yeah. I'm just picturing people going over to, you know, Sauron and Sauron's side, because it's like, hey, look, we don't discriminate. You guys can't fight over there, but, you know, we, pay pretty good benefits. No wage gap with Saruman. So yeah, with the ages, I don't really know exactly, like, how the ages are differentiated. Like, I feel like I'm probably wrong, I feel like the first age was, like, you know, all the stuff with Sauron where he was actually walking around and, you know, swooping people and whatnot. And then once he got killed, that was the second age, and then, I don't know. I'm not really sure where the second and third age got, you know, split apart, but I don't know. So this area is called Eregion. I don't remember if that's how it's pronounced. I know that Gandalf says it at some point in the game, so I don't know. I don't remember how you pronounced it, but I don't know that they were in there in the movie. I don't think they were. So there we go. There's a noise that you know, it's not a clinky noise. It's a little noise of cloth. Not really sure how that fabric is so much better at, you know, protecting him than the other fabric, but whatever. It's some Kevlar. Medieval Kevlar. It's well, it's Mithril, I guess, is Kevlar. I don't know. So yeah, we can't go there because we don't have a map. Which, we didn't have a map of anything else. And, I mean, you got an elf with you who can see all the stuff. Her elf eyes, her special eyes. My brand. Yeah, so we gotta get the map. So now they're really carting those leaves. Like, all these trees are dead. They're carrying them over there in bucket loads. It's like burning wood up in here. Nobody will get that reference. Make that. Has it come to this? I like that when they're just like, folk. It just looks cool. Lily. I feel like in general, Company Valor is a better one than Company Might, because I don't believe that Company Might affects Idril. Like, I don't think it makes her, like, Glower Fury any more powerful. You know, I guess it would make her sword powerful. But I don't think that attack includes spirit attack, so... Glower Fury is really the only one, the only, you know, spirit power that Idril gets for most of the game that does actual damage. Most of her other stuff is, like, you know, healing kind of things, or, you know, haste to the elves or something like that. So that's really the only thing she does that is attacking, except for that other water horse thing, you know, the one that we showed from before, and that she doesn't get till, I think it's one of the last, if not the last, powers she gets. It's easy to turn around in this game, you know, make sure you got everything, so it'd be a little easy to kind of not be sure where you're going exactly. Now, here's one thing I wonder too about the orcs is, did they exist before, like, Sauron? Like, did Sauron make the orcs, or were they just, like, regular dudes for a while? You know, like, just they had their own society of orcs, and then, you know, Sauron, when he was coming to power, was like, hey, buddy, you wanna start, you know, killing people and being evil? And they're just like, okay. And then it was just that from there? I don't know. And plus, before the ring came back, you know, what were they doing? Like, I guess Sauron was still up in the tower as a big eye. They were just kind of chilling there and not doing anything. I don't know. Wouldn't that be nice if one of the Ringwraiths just come by, you know, just walked by that place in the river, you know, way back when it was, you know, still just sitting in the river before Gollum got it. And they're just like, hey, I kind of feel something here, guys. I don't know, it might be the ring. I don't know. It's a river, man. Come on. It's gonna be on finger. Obviously. Kevin. Kevin the Ringwraith, yes. This is a cool little place. I believe this is like the Shadow Altar or Dark Altar or something, which it's glowing, so not great at being a shadow, but okay. I like with this attack of Murder Crows, how it makes the, you know, and there's other ones like it too, where the text kind of, you know, moves around and does that little effect. The group of crows is called a murder. Down to the 3rd annual Orc Bash! And live music, great food, and girls, girls, girls! See, I like how they're these precious artifacts, but they're just sitting out in the middle of nowhere. It's like, hey, I'm just picturing some orc walking around like, hey man, I got all this nice, you know, jewelry, got some elf stones, water protection, all that shit. I was trying to get a good image of this one, and this one the camera would not cooperate. And it's the same thing as before, but it's blue. You know, bluish kind of color, so I wanted to get it, but whatever. Now you can only equip 4 elf stones a person, and so obviously I try to even people out in terms of armor and things like that. The more people you get in your party, the harder it is to, you know, keep a hold of that, but, you know, you want to make sure everybody has roughly the same protection. So you can only wear one of a type. So, like, say you have 2 cracked, you know, elf stones of armor protection, and you already have one on that character. You can't put another one on that character. And sometimes that's annoying, because I know there was a time here in this one playthrough where I had that, I got a second elfstone of something, and I tried putting it on the same character because they had the lowest, like, armor, or whatever it was, and I couldn't. So I put it on the next one. So that's kind of annoying, but it's fine. It's fine. We'll do it live! I'm like, oh yeah, we gotta go and find that dude, I guess. For some reason. Again, like, I really hope Arathor didn't have any plans, because, like, they are just completely ruined at this point.
The dwarf came this way.
He is heavy for one so small.
I'd be careful not to say that around him.
Quiet! Both of you. I hear something.
Well, Ranger, it's about time!
Are all of the dwarves spotted? I guess they are. Because, yeah, in the Hobbit, I think they're all Scottish, too. Like, I would think maybe there's a couple of Scottish, I don't know exactly. But, yeah, it's weird. Especially because, like, everybody else is English, with the exception of Pippin, who is Irish, for some reason. I mean, I love Pippin. I love that guy. You know, I can't remember his name right now, like, the actor's name. But I love that dude. But yeah, so Hadhod, but I didn't. But yeah, he's got some spirit powers too. He's got his flaming fury. This is the guy you saw before. I mean, what? But yeah, he's got his little fireball. He's got his axe and my axe. I want to see a Sean Connery dwarf like you would not imagine. Like, I just want that so badly. Counterattack. Counterattack is great. And it's exactly what it sounds like. You know, somebody hits Barathor, he gets counterattack. He'll just run up and slap him. And he doesn't, it's not like you get to pick what attack it is. Troll clubbing. But yeah, he, with the counterattack, he just, you know, attacks, like, you know, just runs over. And it happens immediately after the attack. So as soon as that happens. Only thing that's not great about it is that it doesn't always happen. Like, there will be some attacks and he just doesn't do that, and I can't find a reason why, per se. I don't think it's a glitch, I just, it doesn't happen. And I'm sure there's an actual reason, I just don't know it. Because I think this is the first time people have been, you know, kind of weakened in health. When they're in the yellowish-green sort of veins there, they won't look any different. But once you get to red, and you'll see it, I think, here a little bit later, possibly, they look, you know, they'll kind of be a little bit weak-looking. They'll kind of be bent over a bit, kind of like, ooh. And, you know, and of course then they can die. So they'll look a little bit bent over. And then if you heal them, then they'll get, you know, better-looking. But yeah, other than that, it's not like they have blood on them or anything like that. And so now that we have four people, it was telling you there, I believe, you can switch out characters. So, you know, if you're in the middle of battle and you're like, hey, I, you know, don't want to keep using that guy, you can switch out. And the good thing about that is when you switch out, it doesn't count as a turn. It's not like, oh, well, you used that turn to switch, so now it's the enemy's turn. You could switch back and forth a million times if you wanted to. You know, until you find, you're like, oh, okay, I want to use that guy, and then you use an attack. So that's good. Here is one of the very few times that I have not cut out the item using, and, to show it off, of course. That's exactly why I kept this in there. no. More Vempus bread. I'm pretty sure that all these things are actual things. The only thing that sounds weird is ent draught file, I think is what it's called. But that sounds weird because it's like, is it made of ents? Like, ents are, like alive. It's kind of weird. So yeah, let's look at his skill tree. You got your axe craft. Wish it would be called Minecraft, that'd be great, because he's a dwarf. But yeah, and you got some spirit powers. I'm gonna be honest, in my original playthroughs, I've never really used Hadhod a whole lot. Because once I get some other, you know, a couple of the other people, I just don't really use him as much. And again, it is definitely useful, and I'd say almost essential, to use all of the characters at least a little bit. I mean, like, certain characters like Idril, like, I'm gonna use her pretty much all the time. Like, if I'm able to use her, I will use her. But, you know, and you'll use other ones a little more often. But you have to use all of them. You know, and kind of keep them up in strength. because if you don't, you know, if you have to use them at some point, like in that section I was mentioning, I mean, that's it. There's a little area here, that little, I guess it was a bridge? You're just kind of sitting there, it's all decayed. Nice looking. Again, the elves were like right by there. I don't know how they didn't notice that Moria was getting its shit, you know, beaten in, but whatever. I guess they didn't talk anyway, but you'd think they kind of notice, hey, notice how all the bridges and stuff are like completely destroyed, and there's like orcs everywhere, and haven't heard anything about dwarves for like a few hundred years. Eh, I'm probably fine.
Look! Elves prowl the shore! Get them all!
I do wonder if, like, elves and men, or elves and dwarves, or whatever, can have children. Like, I don't think they ever address that. I know they don't in movies, but I don't know if they do in the books. They probably don't. It doesn't seem like something that they would necessarily bring up in a book like that, but whatever. It's for the, fanfiction. So here's the Watcher in the water. The Watcher on the wall, I'm in the water. And, so yeah, he shows up. So, it's not exactly clear if they're running behind the Fellowship, like, the Fellowship's like, hey, they just got out of Moria, and they're here. And I actually think, though, without saying anything, I think that they're pretty much right behind them right here. But yeah, I mean, they kind of... So, I mean, with the Watcher in the water, they didn't kill it in the movie, I don't think, but they, like, wounded it. Like, he was pretty much... Like, he wasn't doing too well. So, I don't know. I used to be thinking, oh, surely the LotR fury will not do much to this guy, and it did. So I don't know. I guess the backwater is somehow bad to me, I don't know. Part of the reason that I think that we're right behind the Fellowship is that I believe the Watcher in the Water is missing a little tentacle there. That one kind of cupped up. So yeah, here you go. He's kind of run out. You're like, you know, tag him in. Creature Bane. You know, it's good against creatures, obviously, like dwarves. So I know it works with dwarves. I assume it's doing a better job against the Watcher in the Water than, you know, other things would. Or that it has a benefit. So I'm assuming he's a creature. It's a little vague. It's not like you see things and it's like, oh, this thing, this class, is a creature. So I don't know. I mean, he's not talking. You know, he's not chatting everybody up, so I'm assuming he's a creature. I don't know. And again, too, Flaming Fury, you would think it would not do much because it's in the water. But no, it's pretty good. So I don't know. Tentacle frenzy, oh my goodness. It's very good we didn't actually see that thing. But yeah, I think here, Hathod, I think he was looking a little bit kind of bent over because he's a little low on health. I don't know. I'm looking at a smaller screen, but I think that's in red. I'm 100% sure. The idea of using items in battles, you know, kind of like where you're eating stuff. It's like, oh hey, we're kind of weak, you know what we should do? Here's some brownies. Here, you get some brownies too. You get some brownies. Okay. Alright, let's just chew on it. Alright. Wait a second, buddy. Come on, we're eating. Gotta be fair. Giant tentacle monster. So yeah, we don't really see what happens to him. It's kind of like, well, he's decided to, you know, fuck off. I don't know.
Watch out! Those tentacles are powerful!
Those tentacles are powerful.
Excellent! They're digging a way in!
He has opened the gate!
I knew he was good for something!
we are, Western Moria. This will be our next little section here.
Stand back! It shall be a dwarf who first enters Moria. The rumors are true. Balin has failed. My people
probably
have
could have
failed.
Figured that from the fact that nobody was walking out there like, hey buddy, what's up? Hagrod, how you doing?
These great dwarf lords stood here for thousands of years, Elf, and this abomination took place before them. I do not find that amusing.
Some How did small she say that she found that amusing? She was like, their bodies are dust. Feel it. Hardy her har, I guess. I don't think she found it funny.
For your people.
I really got that with the elves and dwarves. Like, I know that, like, you know, obviously, I know the reason that they didn't like each other, but, like, the elves always seemed, like, relatively nice about it. Like, they were like, they're willing to help out, and dwarves are like, no, fuck you. And it's like, dude, we're leaving here anyway. You're gonna have it, like, all to yourself. You can take over Rivendell, whatever. That's why I think the elves left in the first place. Why they all decided to leave Middle-earth. I think they were just kind of like, you know what? Y'all just deal with this. Okay, we got rid of Sauron for you. He won't be coming after us anymore. Let's just get the heck out of Dodge. I don't know where Dodge is in Middle-earth. So crafting. That is the thing I'm not going to be doing. Basically, you just craft items. And I have to look it up. I think there might be a way eventually somehow that you can craft things.
You come to Rivendell at the bidding of
Lord. See, here's some of the scenes we got going on.
The great captain Boromir has been summoned.
And see, they basically just kind of give you some backstory. So you certainly don't have to have these. You don't have to watch these if you don't want to. And if you want to cut off, really, whatever. But I just like them. You know, they just give you a little bit of backstory. They give you an idea of what's happening in movies. I don't know why you play this game if you haven't watched the movies. Seems kind of stupid to me, but you know, it's totally fine if you didn't.
Now it has found you.
And again, there's like 109 of these, and Gandalf does every single one. You know, so he was committed. It took Sir McClellan a while here.
Shores. For years beyond count, they lived in harmony with this world, awed by its wonders. This elf is a warrior among her kind. Do not underestimate them. Many have lived thousands of years and possess wisdom and ability far beyond.
I feel like the elves must not have kids very much, because there would just be like a whole shit ton of them if they did. I mean, they don't really die. You have to kill them for them to die, so you'd think there would just be a bunch. You know, just all over the place.
The elves forsake Middle-earth, never to return. Some of them shall briefly shelter at Rivendell. But evil grows strong in the Tower of Orsank, for one of my kind now serves the enemy.
What would happen to some of the other wizards, like with, what is his name? Radagast, that's it. Like, maybe it's in the books again. Probably is. But, like, I don't know, what happened to him? He was kind of, you know, I'm fine here in the woods. You know, you guys got it handled. You know, all that, you know, Sauron. You know, all that stuff.
Audacity. Your sword is much needed here.
Later, bitch!
With every elf that sails across the Western Sea, Middle-earth is diminished. Some travel far from the heart of Elvendom on Earth, realm of the Lord.
Elvendom.
Those you met are all that remain of a group that crossed these mountains. They make for the harbor, to the Grey Havens, and then beyond the White Towers.
The Grey Havens sound like a place beyond. That, like, old, really rich people would retire.
But the gift
is some kind of country club.
Is their ability
to
shape
be showing up at
the Grey
Havens?
World.
Here's my swan boat.
LotR is defended by one of the wisest and most wonderful of these ancient beings. She has the ability to see far and peer deep into the soul of others. This realm is far more dangerous than you can imagine, Berathor. The elves guard their ancient ruins and patrol these hills, but their numbers dwindle. The only other force able to offer resistance is a small band of Dunedain rangers. They are the survivors of a fallen kingdom, yet still silently defend these lands.
Yes, because they just kind of run around like they're not... Like, and they're, you never see them all together.
Now, huge wargs roam the country.
Yeah, see, look, they all have riders.
They will slay many who individual. Are innocent of the danger. Unless you lend the rangers.
But all of them have riders, so.
Yes, you have found a place where the ancient spirits of air, fire, earth, and water, who once graced this world, may still be found. Some beings glide through the airs around you, timeless and wise.
That thing is creepy. Ugh.
Mighty forces also stir the deep. And can still be called upon in times of great need.
But only every once in a while, and then not until the end of the game.
Life to this realm, and are held by the wise as the most potent and dangerous forces. Great spirits of the earth yet animate the living wood of this world, for it too breathes the mystery of life. Elves are the keepers of this wisdom and guardians of this ancient force, for make no mistake about it.
So yeah, y'all get to, control the trees now and stuff, so, bye.
Is some small
hope you all deal with it.
Of the gods.
That is like the only mention of the gods, as far as I know. In like the, you know, because like, they don't mention the actual gods or anything in any of this.
For it contains power beyond measure.
I could just go to sleep listening to Anna Plone's voice. He's the best voice.
Ah, I see you have found.
And then I realized we had already seen that.
I will lay open to you Moria's secrets, and they are many.
I feel like Gandalf kind of, you know, kind of made that mistake there in not saying, hey, you know, we shouldn't go there. Reason being, everyone's dead. And there's like a giant fire monster and he's gonna like kill people. There's orcs in there and stuff. Like, probably should not go that way. Maybe wait till it's not like, you know, storming and stuff.
Should the gates be mastered, the mazes of halls and tunnels within the mountain are vast. The four-day journey to the other gate will not be an easy one, should foul creatures still prowl those halls. If I were you, I would track our party and follow behind, should we master the gates of Moria. War is soon to come to our time. Even now, Saruman sends forth his cruel orc servants.
Sometimes he says Saruman, and sometimes he says Saruman. I like Saruman better. Like it feels more like the other words in this, but I don't know.
Understand that a great eye watches all in the darkness, building in power as it prepares to destroy this world.
I am the fire of the giant.
In your mind. Saruman rallies the wild men to his cause.
Gandalf is speaking
they
in our minds.
They will pour forth here and in Rohan, burning as they go. I would suggest you find the dwarf quickly.
Go,
before
Packers!
Before Saruman wins his war in this land. This dwarf who joins your company heralds from a people who hold themselves apart from other races.
They are
a race that feels deeply, and when deciding upon trust, their friendship lasts many lives.
Well, okay, that's not why.
I have met a few of these stout fellows in my time. They appear small, but are not to be trifled with. Do remember, as you enter their ancestral home, that their pride, greed, and stubborn magnificence created this now decaying wonder.
So maybe we shouldn't be leaving them around with this mystical ring that's the most powerful thing on Earth. I don't know.
7 rings of power were given to the Dwarf Lords, great miners and craftsmen of the Mountain Halls. But they were deceived by the Dark Lord, Sauron. And in time, their kingdoms fell into ruin. But the dwarves hold many secrets, and few are graced to share their language.
I don't think we ever really hear Dwarvish. Of their ancient like, I don't feel like we ever hear that in
these empty halls.
In movies or
it is your secret to find.